your wife. I lose your stronghold from the life of your parents. I lose their stronghold in the name of Jesus from the life of your brothers and sisters by the power of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. I address every power that does not make people to sleep at night. Every power that does not make people to sleep at night. Every power that is waiting for people also to sleep before it starts operation today in the name of Jesus. Anyone that watches this tonight in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I declare everyone that will be watching this video, that will be watching me in any channel they are using to watch me, I declare and I decree that their home will be a no-go area for witches to fly. Their home will be a no-go area for the powers of darkness to operate. In the mighty name of Jesus, I use the name of Jesus Christ to make a seal over your home. You that is watching me right now, anyone watching me, the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says it's a mighty strong tower. The righteous runs into it and they are saved. Hallelujah. You that is constantly crying, you don't know what to do anymore. You said, I've been serving God. All this while, why has God forsaken me? Why has God left me? Let me tell you, our God is a very good God. Our God is a very, very wonderful God. He is the God that helped in the very time of trouble. He said, call upon me in the day of trouble and I will heal you. I will deliver you. Ah, my God, my God, my God, my God. He didn't end there. He said, and I will show you great and mighty things that you do not know. That is our God for you, and God cannot lie. Like the song I sang just now. For God to lie, heaven and earth will pass away. God is not a man to lie, neither the son of man to repent. What he says he will do, he will surely do. He's a very good God. Hallelujah. He wants to see you fulfill your destiny. He wants to see you move to the next level in life. Hallelujah. He's loading you with daily benefit every day. So don't be afraid. It's just like this man. Let me tell you a very short story for you to know that this God, this our God, his name is Jehovah. His name is Elohim. He's the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the all-sufficient God, the great I am that I am, the one that make way where there seems to be no way, the one that destabilize and disorganize and render powerless the power of Nebuchadnezzar, the one that divided the Red Sea. Hallelujah. He is a mighty God. He is a mighty God. You see how he disgraced Nebuchadnezzar? Well, Nebuchadnezzar said to the three Hebrew men, said, I will see, you measure Shadrach and Abednego, Daniel, I want to see who is your God. Why will you not bow down to me? I want to see who is your God. By the time I throw you into that fire, he now hit the fire. The Bible says Nebuchadnezzar tell the men to hit the fire 10 times more. And when they hit it, why? Because the three men of God, Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, and Daniel 4, they refused to bow down to him. Because those ones, they have made up their mind. Just as I'm telling you, make up your mind. Don't be afraid of any situation. Nobody can harm you. Nobody can kill you. Nobody can destroy you. God is always there to help you. God is always there to pick you up. God is always there to push you to the next level. Even though you are thrown into the fire, he demonstrated it in the life of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego when they were thrown into the furnace of fire. Hallelujah. Read the book of Daniel, you will see it there. Glory be to God. When Nebuchadnezzar said to these people, he said, if you do not worship my God, which is idol, I will set that fire and I will put you inside. The Bible says he hit the fire 10 times more. The fire was like something. Even you, the fire is there. You that even near the fire, it will burn you. So they banded Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego. They throw them into the furnace of fire. Hallelujah. The Bible says when they got into the fire, instead of the fire to be burning them, the fire turned into an air-conditioned room. Glory be to God. And the people who were watching, they said, but we threw only three people inside the fire. But I can see the fourth person there. I can see there are not four people. But we only throw three people. The Bible said, Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, instead of the fire to be burning them, the fire was not giving the AC, air condition. Their skin was more refreshing. Their skin was more. Why? Because before they got into the fire, the Almighty God was already waiting there by his power. Hallelujah. He sent an angel of rescue to go and rescue them, because you know what? The word of God cannot fail. God said, even though you go through fire, even though you go through situations, I am there right with you to set you free, to give you, to put smile in your mouth. No one can destroy you successfully. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter how many they are. It doesn't matter how they came. It doesn't matter which way they came. My God in heaven is giving you a rescue angel tonight in the name of Jesus by the power of the Holy Ghost. Angel of rescue. That same angel that rescued Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego out of fire. Do you not see that our God cannot lie? Our God cannot lie. Even when Nebuchadnezzar say, what is this? Instead of them, by now, you're supposed to be seeing their bones. People that were thrown into heat fire. Look, the degree of that fire is unspeakable. It was red. But when they got inside, their skin become more fresh. Very fresh. That is our God for you. He has not changed. He's still doing it today. He's still doing it today. He's still doing it today. All you just need is to give your love to him. Give yourself to him. Trust him. Believe in him. It doesn't matter what is happening around you. Believe in him. He has given you a name that is above every name. And at the made mention of the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, everyone ganging up against you, God will disgrace them because you are using that name. The Bible says every tongue must confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Those that are ganging up against you, not until they come to come and look for your Jesus, they will not have peace. They will not have rest. So why are you bothered? He said, leave this battle for me. He said to Moses, he said, Moses, tell the people, this fight is not their fight, it's for him. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ has given us his name. Use the name of Jesus to stop every situation. Use the name of Jesus. You are going through a situation. Keep on praying. In the name of Jesus Christ, I stop this affliction. In the name of, it may not stop immediately. Hallelujah. Why? Because maybe the rate of your faith. Amen. So as you begin to use it, your faith is developing. Your faith is developing. Your faith is developing. One day you will see that situation, you will not see it anymore. Hallelujah. Let me tell you a very short story. There is this young man. This young man is a very strong believer, a very good believer. Hallelujah. A very, very good believer. And you know when you are walking in the sand, when you are walking in the sand, or when you are walking with bare feet, when you are walking with bare feet, you will always see your footprint on the ground. When you are walking, there are some places you go, you know, especially when you are walking in the sand. When you put your bare foot down, you will see the footprint of the foot there. When you put your hand like this also, when you remove your hand, you will see the footprint of your hand there. So this man, always, all his life, when he's walking, he always see extra 2 footprints. When he's walking, he's walking like this. On the other side, there will be another extra footprint of somebody walking. So he says that somebody is always walking with him. He's either by the side or ahead of him. You know, it's either he will see first the 2 footprints, he will also go and pass, or as he's walking, always, all his life, he was now panicking. He was now afraid. He said, what is this? I don't understand. All my life, always 2 footprints. I know my own. My own, I go. 2 footprints that I'm passing. But this extra one feels for, what is that? Is it demonic attack? Is it the enemy after me always walking with me? Because this is the footprint of somebody. Hallelujah. Always walking. This guy went to prayer and fast to God to ask God, God, what is the meaning of this affliction? What is this? All my life, you know, two extra footprints is always going with me. What is that, Lord? Please deliver me. Please save me. You know, he went to God in fasting and prayer to ask God, what is the meaning of that? Because he was already afraid. And you know what? God told him. He said, listen. Jesus answered him and said, listen, that two extra footprints you are seeing belongs to him. It's for him, Jesus. I have promised to be with you till the end of time. I have promised to go with you anywhere you go. I have promised that I will not leave you and I will not forsake you because I am Jesus, because you love me. I have promised, or have you not studied your Bible? I have promised to be with you until the end of time. I am Jesus. I am not a man to lie. What I say in the Bible is who I really am. I have that. So that 2 footprints you are seeing, the one you are using is for you. The other extra one is for him. So the guy was so happy. Jesus. Oh, no wonder I read it in the Bible. You said you would be with me till the end of time. Oh, Jesus, you are truly with me. I believe it now. This guy came out happy and jubilating. And, you know, he was so excited and everything was just going well fine. You know, so it came to one day. It came, one day came. This guy fell into a very deep situation. Hallelujah. Jesus is with you does not mean you will not have situation. But he has promised that in every situation you are coming out triumphantly. He didn't promise that you won't have situation because he's with you. He didn't promise that you won't have temptation. He didn't promise that troubles will not come. He didn't promise that you will not go through stuff. You will go through stuff big time. You know, but he promised that he has promised to help you. He has promised that whatever it is that you go through, it will not destroy you. He will bring you out. Hallelujah. That is his promise. He didn't say that because you believe in him, you will not have situation. No, Christians have situations. Don't make mistake about that. That because I'm not a Christian, so I should be trouble-free. No. No one is trouble-free, but Jesus has promised to help us, to bring us out. So this man, when he now fell into a trouble, big trouble. When I mean big trouble, I mean big-time trouble. You know? He was not saying, Jesus promised to say, I went to Jesus some time ago. He said he's always with me. He said he will not leave me nor forsake me. I'm in this dilemma, for I'm in this situation. And now, when I'm walking on the street, I don't see another footprint anymore. I don't see another footprint anymore. I only see just my own footprint. I only see just two. Normally, it was four, my own, and another extra. And I went to God. He told me that that extra one is for him. He has promised to be with me. But now I have a situation. I don't see the extra footprint anymore. He went to God again in fasting and prayer. I said, Lord, you said you promised to be with me. Always, you are always with me. You are always with me to help me. You are always with me. I came to you in fasting and prayer some years ago. You said that was your footprint. You are always with me. But now, I am in trouble. I don't see your footprint anymore. You don't walk with me anymore. Lord, does that mean that you violate your law? Because now, I only see two footprints. I don't see the extra two anymore. And Jesus answered him and said, listen, my son, my word is established forever. I am not a man to lie. I have promised to be with you. You see those two footprints you are seeing. It's not yours. It's him. It's for him, Jesus. It's for him, Jesus. Because in the time of trouble, I carried you. I am carrying you. I am carrying you. So as I carry you, you won't see extra footprint. You will only see two. And that two that you are just seeing, that two footprint you are seeing is for me. That one on left and right that you are seeing is for me. So I carried you. Hallelujah. I carried you. Jesus carried us in the time of trouble. Jesus lifts us in the time of trouble. He is always there. He said, if you go through fire, I'm there with you. If you go through water, I'm there with you. If you go through situations, I'm there with you. The name of Jesus has been highly exalted above every other name. And at the mention of the name of Jesus Christ, every troubler of your soul tonight, I say they are dropping dead in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I want to hear a very big hallelujah and amen to that. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You heard the story I've just told you now? Jesus Christ said to the guy, when he went to him in fasting and prayer, he said, Lord, you have promised to be with me. And now I have a situation. I only see one footprint. One footprint. I don't see another extra. And Jesus said, that one footprint that you are seeing belongs to him, Jesus. He is the one that is now walking because he carried you. He carried you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I see Jesus carrying somebody today. I see Jesus lifting somebody.